Hello, everyone. I hope you're all doing well. We'll talk about battle formations in this video. This is the ultimate guide. So be sure to stick around until the very end. So, without further ado, let's get started. So, first and foremost, you must understand assigned position. It's more of a permanent position. When all 9 types of troops are sent, the formation looks like this. It's what I call a 4x4 formation, with 4 troop types on the front line and back line. Even cavalry, even infantry, odd cavalry in the front line. Even mages, even archers, odd mages for the back line. Angels are positioned behind the lines of the odd infantry troops. So, if you only deploy 2 or 3 troop types, everything changes. Right center formation. Let's assume the example of only 1 front line. When only 1 type of front line is sent, it will be placed in the center. It is, in fact, in the right center. So, whatever troop type it is, it will be positioned here. Let us now discuss center formation. When you send 2 troop types, one will go to the left center position, and the other will go to the right center position. Right-sided formation. It will look like this if you only send 3 different troop types. It has a tendency to lean to the right. The center spot is mostly filled initially, followed by the last one on the right side. Even cavalry is given first priority. After that, only even infantry and odd infantry are allowed. Finally, there's the odd cavalry. The filler formation. Without angels, this is the finest offensive formation for cavalry and mages. This is a great example. The enemy's heavy side backline must first hit all of these targets, before moving on to the attacker's heavy side. They will only attack the heavier side front line after the 15th second, as you can see. Meanwhile, odd mages inflict a great deal of damage on the troops. The mobility of the troops and the use of fake targets allows for a lot of time. We may also use infantry and archers in the same way. However, it does not have a significant advantage. With angels, the 2x2 formation is the finest. Dummy targets will be used on one side. Angels and backline are covered by a heavy front line. And there is angel up front formation. Only angels and backline should be sent. However, you'll need excellent stats to accomplish so. The majority of people prefer a 1x1 formation. The issue with this setup is that it helps the defender. Encircle formation. And this is the top defensive formation. The troops will encircle the frontline troops. To move forward, they must clear all front lines. Only then will they be able to target backline troops. Backline troops were stationed in an excellent position to hit targets in the meantime. The drawback is that they are unable to form this structure by itself. If the defender is weak, the attacker can easily break through and win. Let's discuss about team attack formations in more detail. Troop range. Different troop types have different ranges for hitting targets. If troops are not within range, they will move and begin to strike. Zero protection. This is an issue that many alliances face. If you're deploying equal troops to all 4 front lines, a 4x4 arrangement is acceptable. Mages are currently without protection. In this case, the defender killed the front line, as shown in the image. After that, they began to go forward. Eventually, they was able to eliminate all of the troops. Then they got into a fight. Archers are hitting angels at the moment. Locking targets. As a result, the target is set to hit angels. After a while, the cavalry pushes ahead, but they are still being hit. Once the target has been locked, they will not be able to change their focus, unless they die. When battling solo, there aren't many possibilities for battle formations. For a team attack, everyone must be in the proper formation. It might go wrong if one of the guys sends a different formation. The first individual to arrive at the battle sends all troop types, according to this report. As a result, we've got a 4x4 formation. Cavalry, on the other hand, die in a split second. And the next individual to enter the battle does send either 2 or 1 troop type. As a result, the cavalry attempted to take up a central position. Center position rule. If troops die, it is not essential to fill the positions. If you just send 1 or 2 troop types, they will only proceed to the center. They are not in the same line as them, rather, they are behind them. There is also no need to send 200,000 archers. They must safeguard the heavy side, which consists of mages, for them. Let's take a look at another report. It will begin with a 3x4 formation. Even infantry were stationed here in the 5th second. And forcing angels with no protection. What happened was that, one of the guys only sent 1 troop type. Center position breach. If only 1 troop type is present, and you send 1 different troop type, it will be placed in the left center position. One of the most major drawbacks of the speed attack is poor timing. Everyone must stay in proper formation and arrive at the 3-second mark. If this is not the case, the front line's position can be changed. The same rules, as well as others, apply to the back line. As a result, sending only 2 troop types is optimal. You can send all troop types. Make certain, however, that the heavy side front line stays behind the heavy side back line. Angel position. Angels are usually seen in the right center position. However, angels are positioned at the left center position in this report. What happens is that, the first person to arrive to the battle does not deploy angels. The next person sends a different troop type, this time with angels. As a result, it is relocated to the left center position. Golems also play a role in battle formations, although, that will be discussed in a future video. One request I make is that, if you guys notice any glitches, like these in the reports, please submit it as a bug. If you have any questions, feel free to post them in the comments section. That's all for today's video. Thank you for watching. I'll be back next week with a new video.